on voter protections. As the civil rights community prepares this week for the National Voting Rights March that Martin Luther King III and I, as president of National Action Network, will lead to Capitol Hill this coming Saturday. And it's there, the Hill, that we want to start with the most timely guests possible. Joining me now, California Congresswoman Barbara Lee, who sits on the House Appropriations Committee. Congresswoman Lee, thanks for joining us tonight. 20 years ago, I remember it because you distinguished yourself. You were the lone House voice and the lone House vote against military force in Afghanistan. You now chair the House Appropriations Subcommittee on State and Foreign Operations. What is your reaction to what we just heard moments ago from President Biden on the U.S. commitment to Afghanistan at this point?
Sure, Reverend Al, thank you so much for giving me a chance to be with you this afternoon. First of all, what I voted against was the 60-word authorization that established that any president could use force in perpetuity. And it was 60 words, and it was a blank check, and there was no way that I could vote for that because I knew that there was no military solution in Afghanistan, and I also understand that we can't go around the world and nation build. I'm really supportive, I would say, of the president and everything that he has done. He has been very clear about his decision and why it was necessary to begin the withdrawal. But he's also been very clear in talking about how he has owned this whole effort in terms of the evacuation, and it has not gone well. I don't think anyone, not even himself, agrees with that. He said earlier, it's dangerous, it's perilous, it's unprecedented. But I do believe that what he says he means, and that is he is going to get every American, every African, Afghan ally, every woman and child, and everyone who needs to get out of Afghanistan who has supported the American presence there, he will do that, including our NATO and European allies.
Now, let me go to this, Congresswoman. You had your colleague Terry Sewell of Alabama with us last night. She was adamant that the John Lewis Voting Rights Advancement Act could pass the House this week. And as I mentioned, voting rights demonstrators will be held in many cities Saturday. We, Martin and I, doing the major one on Saturday in the Washington, going from Black Lives Matter Plaza to the Capitol. Congresswoman Sewell, Chairman of the Caucus, Beatty, and others will be joining Martin Luther King III and I and thousands, leading the main march for voting rights in Washington that day, right to the Capitol. So it would seem that public and political pressure, specifically defending voting rights, is a concerted effort, as it has been. And yet, I acknowledge there's no guarantee that it will be enough to change Republican minds, let alone votes. Do you think this legislation can pass where H.R. 1 did not, Congresswoman, and that we should put the pressure on a carve-out or the end of the filibuster if it passes the House this week? Our objective of the march would be to address that.
Thank you, Reverend Al, and it's because of your leadership and the leadership of the people's movement that's going to allow our voting rights and our democracy to be protected. I agree. Congresswoman Sewell has been a champion and is very clear on the strategy as it relates to the John Lewis Voting Rights Act. I believe it's going to pass the House this week, so it's not about the House. It really is about the Senate. Of course, I have always said that we need to get rid of the filibuster. H.R. 1 also passed the House. This gets dark money out of politics, along with other efforts to address voter suppression. And so we have got to understand, we have the House, we have the Senate, and we have the White House. And so it's going to be the power of the people, it's going to be the pressure, it's going to be the outside movements that's going to get the Senate to act so that we can restore our voting rights and stop these voter suppression laws. This is a real test of our democracy, and those who believe in democracy in the Senate will support both bills. Reverend Al, can I just take a minute to wish Reverend Jesse Jackson and Mrs. Jacqueline Jackson a speedy recovery, heartfelt prayers, and a heck of a lot of love for myself and for my congressional district. The 13th congressional district includes Oakland and Berkeley.
Absolutely.
We're praying for this speedy recovery.
I'm going to do something on that later in the show. I still have a picture in my office of you and Reverend Jackson and myself, Danny Glover, at the elections in South Africa, 1994. We've done a lot of stuff all over the world together, all of us. Let me ask you this, Congresswoman. NBC News has America giving Joe Biden mostly positive marks approaching Labor Day. But still, he's taking what appears to be his first hit. His approval rating now down 4 points from April to 49%, and largely due to the resurgence of COVID-19. Where just over half of America now approves of his response, a 16-point drop over the last 4 months. And are you at all worried that the spike in COVID-19 cases will impede the Democrats' agenda as we head into the end of the year?
The president, first of all, and the Democrats have been very clear on the fact that we have got to address the coronavirus and crush this virus. The Delta variant, of course, has wreaked havoc on the American people. Look at what is happening in so many of our communities, black and brown communities around the country. But let me tell you, Reverend Al, it is so important that the anti-vax messages, somehow we've got to overcome them, because this is what you're seeing, the confusion around those who believe that vaccinations and that masking are not important to save lives. It's a very arrogant in many ways position. And so we have to make sure our voice is heard and that we get the message out that we've got to get the vaccines and that we have got to stay masked and do exactly what our health protocols and what the Biden administration is suggesting that we do. It's so important that we pass this infrastructure bill and the jobs plan this week. And this will, again, show that the Biden administration is definitely working for the people. He's creating more jobs. We're lifting children out of poverty by the passing the child tax credit. We're addressing climate change, environmental injustice. And so this president and this administration, working with House Democrats and hopefully soon with some Republicans, we're working to make sure that people's economic security and that their health security is intact. And so, of course, the president is going to have all kinds of issues that are going to come up. He's the president, but he's owning it. He's being honest about it. He has a lot of integrity, and we're working with him to make sure we get voting rights passed, protect our democracy, crush this virus, and then make sure that everyone has a good-paying job and lift our children out of poverty.
And that segues beautifully to my next guest. Thank you, Congresswoman Barbara Lee, because joining me now is Congress